All right, I love these guys and these girls. Give it up for Skillet!
Thank you. We came here tonight to let you know this. The Bible says Jesus came to give good news to the poor and to set you free. So whatever you're sick of tonight, I want you to put it up in your hands to Jesus. Come on, put it up. Raise your hands if you're sick. If you're sick of it, raise your hands if you're sick. If you're sick of it, raise your hands if you're sick. If you're sick of it, raise your hands if you're sick. If you're sick of it. Yeah. church, how's everybody feeling out here? Woo! This is my fourth time playing Winter Jam, but it's my very first time doing Winter Jam West Coast. And you people are loud! Now I think we're gonna have to come back again. You people are nice tonight. Now listen, I have a very strange request, but some of my really good friends were supposed to come tonight and they ditched me at the last minute. So, you know what they get in return? Here's what they get. 10,000 people telling them they're losers on my phone, okay? Let's rehearse this. Here's what's gonna happen. I'm gonna count to three, and we're all gonna say, Brian and Jay are losers. It's not very Christian, but it's very awesome. Let's rehearse. One, two, three. Brian and Jay. Ooh, that was awesome. Hold on, let me get my camera on. What's up? We are here without you, Brian and Jay, and this crowd has something they want to say to you. One, two, three. Brian and Jay are losers. Okay. That was a test to see how many of you people are mean. Everybody. I think we should take a picture for Instagram here. Make some noise, people. I'm gonna post this right now. It is John L. Cooper. You can see yourself looking awesome. John L. Cooper. You guys wanna have some fun with Skillet tonight? Let's do it! You people sound good at Winter Jam. Thank you so much for coming. Staying and watching this play. I appreciate it. I love ya! I see a lot of kids out here tonight. Those are some good parents there. Sing it. You sound good. Oh, for my singers down front. They sound so good. One of my very favorite Bible verses says this, and I bet a lot of people here know it. I am not ashamed of... That was okay. These few people down here went to Sunday school. I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ. It is the power of God for salvation for everyone who believes. Somebody say amen now. It's always been one of my favorite scriptures because even as a young boy, when I gave my life to Jesus, I knew when I was 5 years old that Jesus was so amazing. I didn't understand a whole lot because I'm not even smart now. When I was five, I was really dumb. But that Jesus was so amazing, that his love was so great that I just had to tell people about it because it was the best kept secret of all time. And if we believe that Jesus is worth living for, we live in a day today where people talk about what they're passionate about all the time. If you want to raise money for, you know, cats to get married. I don't know why I said cats, I have no idea why, or just animals, you know, you let people get money to anything these days. They love to talk about what they're passionate about. And what I want to know is this, why aren't we more vocal about the fact that Jesus Christ is the absolute greatest love in the world? Why don't we talk about it? There are people giving their lives for Christ today in the world. There are people losing their jobs, their family members. People are put to death today. And we get embarrassed to talk about Jesus to our friends at school. And this isn't about trying to make you feel bad. This is about the fact that we are being bombarded every single day by the world telling us what we can and what we can't believe if we want to fit in. And this is about saying to Hollywood, who cares what you have to say? This is about saying to the celebrities, who cares what you have to say? This is about telling your friends, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, in the locker room, at the football game, who cares what they have to say? Because the only thing we care about is what Jesus has to say. Somebody say amen up in here. Now what I'm noticing is this, that in the world right now, there are a lot of people who don't actually, and I'm not trying to be mean, I'm not trying to put condemnation on people, but hear me. There are a lot of people today who live their lives in such a way that you would never, never, ever believe they were Christian, but they like to say that they are Christians. And what I'm saying today is that it's kind of becoming cool to say you're a Christian. But let me tell you what's not actually cool. What's not cool to the world are people who live like they are Christians. Do you understand what I mean? I'm not saying it's not cool. I'm saying the world doesn't actually think it's great. They love it when people talk about Jesus. They don't like it when people live for Jesus. Do you know what I'm saying? So I think it's time for us to say, this is my year to be more passionate about Jesus than I've ever been before. This is my year to proclaim his greatness everywhere that I go, not just with my mouth, but in my heart and in my life. This is my year to love people more than I love myself. This is my year to not be ashamed of the gospel of Christ. This is my year to not be ashamed that Jesus is my hero. Talking about up ahead. I can't hear you. you doing out here in California? Are you guys getting tired? Do you feel like getting loud? How about here, you feel like getting crazy? How about down front? Do you feel like a monster? Put those hands up, people. The thing inside of me, I never let you see. I keep it caged, but I can't control it. So stay away from me. You made us feel very welcome. Thank you so much. I can't wait. Come see you guys again. We are doing a brand new record right now. Gonna release next year. And then I want to come back and rock with all you people. We love you. Yeah.
one more time for Skillet, everybody. Skillet. You're welcome. You're welcome, dude. Hey, we want to pray for you real quick before you leave. We just love